I'm Akash, and this is your News of the Week for the week of March 28th to April 3rd, 2021. Let's begin with the first story of the week, which is the massive container ship, the Ever Given, has finally been released from the Suez Canal on March 29th, after it was stuck for 6 days straight from March 23rd. And this means that the Suez Canal route has finally become freed again, which means that world trade can continue to pass on as normal, because 10% of the world's trade depends on the Suez Canal. So it's great news that the massive ship Ever Given has finally been released, allowing world trade to continue like it was before. Next, the current status of the COVID-19 vaccinations. The good thing here is that the vaccinations have been increasing, and this is what we want. But there's still two major concerns that is currently going on. The first of which are the new variants, which are starting to spread of COVID-19, including the one in Britain. And the second major concern is that summer is coming, and with this means international travel is on the rise yet again, which worries most countries because it might increase the number of infections. So Western governments have come up with plans to somehow include the COVID-19 vaccinations or the test results in the passport digitally. Now, the European Union has already come up with a plan for this called the Digital Green Certificate, which serves as a sort of vaccine passport. And the US is also seriously considering a similar program. Now, there's one more very important and interesting news with COVID-19, and it relates to the world's largest pharmaceutical company, Pfizer, which is based in America. Now, Pfizer, you may know, is the first company to have its COVID-19 vaccine approved by the FDA. And now, Pfizer is heading for another record, because this vaccine is indicated to adults age 16 and up. But what about those younger? Which means that Pfizer is now conducting clinical trials for children aged 12 to 15 for a new COVID-19 vaccine tailored towards kids so that kids can be vaccinated as well. And that is so cool, because if everything goes according to plan, then that means that this new vaccine will be the very first one to be geared towards children. And that means that kids can be vaccinated too, along with adults as well. And that is awesome. Next, the situation in Myanmar, as protesters continue to demand for the restoration of democracy in Myanmar, where the military had taken over the country just on February 1st. And ever since then, the military junta has wound up killing over 550 peaceful protesters. And this situation is very bad, and I hope that the situation in Myanmar can come to a peaceful end. And this whole junta had come to power on February 1st and stated that they would take full control of the country for a whole year. Well, we're not sure how long this is gonna last, and that's sad. Next, the trial of former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin, who has been accused of killing the black George Floyd on May 25th, 2020, causing major racial division and spurring loads and loads of major protests across the United States and all over the world. The officer responsible for this, Officer Derek Chauvin, has now in trial starting last week, and currently the jurors are hearing the witness testimony, which which involves the witnesses, as most of them in tears, as they recall and reminisce about the events of that fateful day. Now, Derek Chauvin has been accused of killing George Floyd after he was arrested on suspicion of counterfeiting a $20 bill. Now, a senior official said about this that that action was totally unnecessary, and I believe that it is. Next, ending the longest war in the history of the country, the war in Afghanistan. Now, the deadline for this set by the Trump administration, which has been inherited onto the Biden administration, is May 1st for all soldiers from all U.S. soldiers stationed in Afghanistan to return back home. But we will have to see how long it's going to last and what the soldiers will do during this time. And next, the situation in Taiwan after a train derailed, carrying 490 passengers and killing 50 of them and injuring countless others. Now, this situation is very bad, and I hope, and my thoughts and prayers are with everyone involved in the incident. And finally, President Biden's $2 trillion infrastructure plan, which he said was once in a generation and is meant to give an innovative edge to the United States in terms of infrastructure. Now, among other things, this infrastructure plan is meant to help eliminate the racial disparity in infrastructure during the Jim Crow laws of the days in the 1960s and 70s. And that is all of your news of the week for the week of March 28th to April 3rd. Thanks so much for joining me, and we'll see you next week. Goodbye.